Okay, welcome to Talkin' Funny. It's the crazy silly talk show that's on television. Okay, so my name is Sasha. I'm an international hilarious comedian, and usually I host the show with the Noob, but the Noob's not here today. He's a little ill, but thankfully we have this wonderful gentleman, Mr. Sloat, who's going to co-host the show with me. Hello, Mr. Sloat.
Yeah, how you doing, man?
Pretty good. And yourself? Tell us a little bit about yourself, Mr. Sloat.
I'm looking for the Noob's dad.
The Noob's not here right now.
Yeah. That's what you told me.
But maybe after the show we can catch up with the Noob and he can tell you where his dad is. But I don't think they've really...
Yeah, I'm looking for him. He owes me some money for a doll.
Oh,
I sold him.
You're a doll salesman. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about your little dolls that you sell.
You trying to be funny?
Hey. That's part of the show, yeah, it's with Talkin' Funny, to have a fun time.
So. Alright, okay, just take it easy, alright?
Okay.
So yeah, I import-export dolls. From France.
What's with the jazzy music?
Well, right now I don't have a doll.
Okay.
That's actually why I was looking for the Noob's father. He owes me money for a doll, and once I get more money, I can get another doll.
Okay.
And it makes me, it calms me down. It calms me down when I don't have a doll.
You
understand?
A little bit. Yeah, you need the music to calm down when you don't have
like
a doll.
You.
I like you too, mister.
I like you too.
Okay, we have a few games to play. We have some emails to read tonight, but let's have a telephone call. Hello, caller.
Hey, this is Paul.
Hello, Paul. How are you today?
Pretty good. That guy creeps me out. Who is that? He looks dangerous.
This Mr. Sloat. And I don't think he's really dangerous. He's just looking for the Noob to find the Noob's dad. He's probably...
I don't know. Looks dangerous. I think it's dangerous. I'd be careful. I'd be careful if I were you, Sasha.
Who's that?
That's our buddy, Paul. He helps with the show once in a while.
I mean, he's got no right to call me dangerous.
That's
he doesn't
right.
know me. You don't know me, buddy.
Callers, before you do that, maybe ask a little question and get to be buddies. And then, Okay, hello there, caller.
What's up, Sasha?
Hey, it's our buddy David. How are you today?
I'm fine. How you doing?
Good. We missed you, buddy. How have you been?
Yeah, I've been working. Workaholic.
What's work like for you, buddy?
It's wonderful. I work 14 hours a day. I barely have time to come home and watch television.
So what's different about tonight that you can give us a call to say hello?
Well, I'm off today, so... What's up with your character next to you? Because he reminds you of Robert De Niro.
Character? I'm a character?
No, he's a...
I'm a character?
Mr. Sloat.
Are you a character, David?
Of course, I'm a character, of course. Everybody's a character in their own way.
That's a good comeback, David. That's a way to dig yourself out of a very deep hole about
What does he mean by that? Character.
That means it in a nice way, like that you have...
I'm just a man. I'm Mr. Sloat. I'm an importer-exporter, alright?
Of dollies.
Alright, I've seen your show.
Okay, you've been watching the show.
It comes on right around when I get out of bed.
You have a late bedtime.
Yeah, I like to work at night.
Okay.
Okay.
That's fine. Mr. Sloat...
So I brought you some stuff.
Oh, what do you have for us today?
I brought you a mouse.
That's very nice to have. Oh, look, a little bell on the tail.
Yeah, you like that?
I like the mouse. Thank you for the gift.
Yeah, you could stuff it in your mouth if you wanted to.
Okay. If the urge overtakes me, I will stuff the mouse in my mouth.
I'd like to see that.
Okay, we'll put it down for a little bit, but we'll get back to the mouse to stuff it in my mouth. Hey, do you know Mr. Sloat?
That makes me happy.
It's good. Well, hey, caller. Hello there, telephone caller.
What did you say he do with that doll?
What's that?
What does he do with that doll?
Which dolls? I buy and sell dolls from France, honey. What's your name?
Her name is Mrs. Giggle
yeah,
Pains.
She thinks it's funny.
It's not funny. It's pretty serious to buy and sell
They're
dolls.
Very, very unique dolls. Hand carved.
Hey, you know what? It's email time. I want to remind you, if you want to send us an email, we can read it on the television. Send to email@talkinfunny.com. So we have a bunch of emails to get through tonight. We'll do them one at a time.
You like chocolate?
I do like that.
Maybe you could have some chocolate.
Stuff the Dove chocolate in my mouth.
I like chocolate.
Okay. Parker Stetch writes us.
You like chocolate, Mary Beth?
Mary Beth is the girl on the telephones.
Good catch. Okay. I like that girl.
Hi, Sasha and the Noob. My friend and I are having a pretty big disagreement about your pants. He says that you and the Noob are wearing sparkly silver slacks. I, however, say that you are both wearing the bottom half of a chicken suit. Who's right? Have a noobtastic day. Well, Parker, that's very easily solved. It's chicken legs that we have.
That's crazy, man.
We wear chicken legs,
that's
so...
That's crazy.
Parker, you were right. Mr. Sloat does not have chicken legs on. He's just got regular people legs.
Chicken legs, that's nuts. That's out of this world, man.
That's right. Okay, let's have a telephone call. Hello, caller.
This is Michael Leslie, celebrity name dropper.
Hello there, Michael. What can we do for you?
Recently, I was dining at Spago's with Sid Vicious when we came on Bia Zadora and Mr. Drysdale.
Okay, thank you very much for the update. We hope to talk to you next week as well, I mean.
You're talking about Mr. Drysdale from the Beverly Hillbillies?
It's very possible, I don't know.
It's not a celebrity, that's a character.
I would like...
That's a character.
There you go.
From a TV show.
Hey, well, have another email. It says, to Sasha and the Noob. My girlfriend is a nice dork and watches your show. She found out recently that she has free basic cables. She made me watch last week. Now I like the show too. Can you say hello to Trisha for me on the show? I sent a picture of Trisha as well. Okay, well, let's say hello. This is his darling Trisha. This is very nice, say.
Holy crap, that...
Hello, Trisha.
That bra was ugly.
Now, this is this boy's girlfriend, Trisha. I think she's very darling.
Holy shit.
Hello there, Trisha. It's good to hear from Paul and Trisha. Hopefully we'll hear from you again.
I found something else for you. It's a fuzzy ball.
Tastes wonderful, Mr. Sloat. Thank you for the gift.
It's a fuzzy ball.
I'll put it with the fuzzy mouse. Okay, hello there, telephone caller.
Can we get rid of Mr. Sloat? He's like a hitman. Can we bring on the dancing girl, Sloat, please?
Sloat, get it right, lady.
I ain't no lady.
Sloat.
Play with your dial someplace.
Sloat. Sloat.
What's your name, buddy? His name is Click and Hang.
Sounded like a chick.
It sounded like Trisha, kind of. Like the,
yeah,
the beautiful
that
Trisha.
Ugly, you said I shouldn't say, no, bitch.
It's okay, so long as you keep it in moderation, Mr. Sloat. Okay, another email from our buddy.
I didn't like that last caller.
No, this was...
I didn't like you at all.
So maybe it's best that callers only call if you have something nice to say to Mr. Sloat.
Or to you.
To me as well.
Sasha.
Okay. Hello, Sasha and the Noob. I'm sorry I haven't emailed you guys in 6 weeks. I was very busy. I guess I could say, long time, no email. Well, anyways, there is no possible way for you to shoot Schnipsy in the head because I drew him a helmet, a glass helmet. Everyone knows that bullets can't penetrate glass. Well, hopefully I remember to email you next week. From Zach. And then here is Schnipsy now. He has a helmet. And then no guns. So, Mr. Sloat, in your experience, can a glass helmet block against bullets?
Is that a monkey?
This an Ewok, actually.
An Ewok?
Yeah, Schnipsy the Ewok is our friend that we have.
Depends on if it's bulletproof glass or not.
He didn't specify in the email.
Well, if it's not bulletproof glass, Ewok's gonna croak.
Okay, that's good to know.
Part of his brains will splatter all over the other side of that glass, too.
Okay, so maybe that's something you should keep in mind there, Schnipsy. Hey, let's say hi to our buddy Army. Army cheers me up greatly. Hey, hello there, caller.
How you doing?
Pretty good. How are you today, buddy?
I'm good. I like Mr. Sloat. Sloat. I like your style. I'm from the Bronx, New York.
I like you too, buddy. What's your name?
My name is Jay Rand. They call me Gambino. I'm a friend of the family.
Right on, brother. I'd like to meet you in an alley sometime.
You know what? You know what's life about, though? You know, it's about the rules and the parameters, you know?
That's right. You gotta
have... Don't go through it as a man's man. You say, suck it up. Take the fall. Do the time, you know?
That's right. I know what you're talking about. This guy speaks my language.
That makes you who you are, you know? That makes you what you are. How long have we been around this Costa Nostra, this thing about? I mean, 20 years.
You're a good man. You're a good man.
Okay,
I'm going to send you a nice bottle of something.
You know, Don Perignon or maybe Moet Chandon, you know, Louis XIII.
Hey, I'll send you whatever I want, all right?
Okay, calm down. What's wrong with this guy? What do you got, man?
You tell me to calm down?
Then he told you to calm down.
Hit that button.
Okay, thank you very much for the telephone call. Hello there, caller.
Hey, tough guy.
Which one? You talking to me or this guy?
The exporter there. What, he got blow-up dolls or what?
No, they're just little ceramic dolls, right?
What is this?
Maybe he wants to buy some dolls from you.
Look, I was feeling good, okay? I came in here, I was looking for the noob's dad, I was feeling good. Now you got these people calling in.
I don't know, they probably
hate the
wrong number.
Maybe it's time for another game.
Okay.
You ever play that hide the peanut?
Yeah, we do have hide the peanut.
Yeah, I like that game.
Okay, let's have a caller. Hello there, caller. Hello there.
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, we're playing hide the peanut.
I
said we're playing hide the peanut.
Well, hide it in
all right,
the
booty
hole.
So tell us where to hide the peanut.
And this caller didn't want to play. Hello there, caller. Hello there, caller. Hello there, caller.
Hello.
Do you want to play hide the peanut?
Yeah, I'd like to play hide the peanut.
Where do you want to hide the peanut?
Under number 5.
It sounds like Paul.
It sounds like our buddy Paul.
It's not Paul.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. No.
All right.
Find the peanut.
All right.
Find it.
Where's the peanut?
That sounds like
number
Paul.
5.
Let's have a look.
Ask Mr. Sloat what's in his dolls. Maybe you'll find a peanut in his dolls.
Mr. Sloat, do you have peanuts in your dolls?
The dolls. They got stuffing in them.
They're just dolls with stuffings.
Right. They use down stuffing. They got wood in there. There's all kinds of stuff. It looks like the inside of your couch.
Hey, you know,
like if you were to cut open your couch with a knife.
Okay.
Look at the inside of your couch. That's what the inside of a doll looks like.
We have another game to play. Do we have a caller that wants to have a play? Hello, caller.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. What's your name, buddy?
My name is Lewis.
Lewis, do you want to play Find the Differences?
I would kill to play that.
Okay, buddy. Here we have two pictures of Timekeeper Willis. Now, there's exactly 10 differences. Can you name a couple?
Okay, first of all, he's dead in one of them, and he's alive in the other. Second
yeah.
Of all,
what's wrong with this guy?
That's wrong.
They're all visual.
Yeah, try to look for visual
They're
cues.
All visual.
Okay, let's see. I'm one of them. He has pink socks.
It's the most clear one.
Thank you, Mr.
The
Slug.
First one, he's got pink socks, okay? There's one.
No. He's not wearing any socks. He's with a girl.
Get rid of this guy.
Okay, this guy does not know how to play the game. Hello there, caller.
Hey, y'all. What's up?
Hello, Mel. How are you today?
I am wonderful.
Mel, you have to find the differences. We have one that he has pink socks. What's another one?
That fantastic tattoo on his right shoulder.
That's right. You found the tattoo. That's the second difference. Thank you, Mel. Hello there, caller.
Somebody with a brain.
That's true. What's up there, buddy?
I want to ask about the beautiful music in the background.
Okay, what's that?
It's Miles
Pretty
Davis.
Good. Oh, yeah?
Kind of blue.
It's good stuff.
It is. Classic jazz.
Yeah.
Classic jazz.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
I know what you're talking about, man. I know what you're talking about.
Okay, well, have a caller to play a game with
See,
us.
We got people that understand.
Okay, Mr. Sloan, that's right. Nice, and maybe he needs to go somewhere and spank his monkey and
Okay, listen to me. There will be no monkey spanking on this show. If you want to discipline a monkey, you call Talking About Monkeys this show. I apologize for that one, Mr. Sloan.
It's all right. I've had worse things said to me.
Probably. Hello there, caller.
Hello
there, what's your name, buddy?
Hi, I'm Matt.
Matt, do you want to help us find the differences?
Okay, either that or we'll play Hide the Peanut. Either one.
We'll play Find the Differences.
Okay, alright. One of them.
Now Sasha's getting tough.
That's right. Okay, what's that, Matt?
One of them has a bow tie.
That's right, that's the third difference. Thank you, Matt, buddy. We got 7 more differences.
Three.
Hello there, caller.
So
Hello there.
Hello.
Hello, how are you today?
I'm fine, how are you?
Thanks, I'm pretty good. What's your name?
My name is Wanda.
Wanda.
Hello, Wanda.
What can we do for you tonight?
I want to play The Differences.
That is wonderful.
Good for you.
Find the difference, Wanda.
Good for you,
one
Wanda.
Has chest hair and the other doesn't.
That's
right.
That's right. That's number four.
That's right.
Do you want
to,
five?
Do you want to try for the fifth?
The fifth? The images on the clock. One is facing the right, one is facing the left.
You're wonderful,
wow.
Wanda. That's five differences
Wanda
and there are
shut.
Five to go. Wanda, what do you do for a living?
I'm a social worker.
Tastes good. You're also a find the differences.
You want to know another difference?
Hey, if you got them, we'll take them, Wanda.
You get one more, I'll give Sasha another present.
That's true. What do you got, Wanda?
Chest hair.
Besides the chest hair and the bow tie.
Nobody
and
said the chest hair yet.
The chain is missing in one.
That's
nobody
right,
said
the chain
chest
is
hair.
Missing. And the chest hair.
All right, so you get a
we're
present.
We're at a bunch now. Wanda, it's time for me to have a present. I wonder
Sasha
what it's going to be.
A little present. It's a nice looking bag.
Oh, a nice looking bag.
Yeah, it's a hefty, it's a nice sized bag.
I love bags. I could really use a bag.
There you go. You can use that for whatever you want. It's good for you.
Thank you for the bag.
It makes you feel good.
Yeah, that's right, because I can put things in the bag to carry them around. I will feel wonderful.
No, you can use the stuff that's in the bag.
Okay, yes, I will use the bag to carry things around. Hello there, caller.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, a little slow for the show, but hello there, caller.
Yes, hello.
Hello there.
Michael Leslie, celebrity name dropper.
Great, Michael Leslie. What's the update now?
I'm sitting on a bus with Mr. Muhammad Ali. And we wanted to hide the peanut.
You want to hide the peanut? Okay. Where would you like to hide the peanut?
Number two.
Number two, let's do that. Let's take the peanut. Oh, he already was in two, but let's hide them in number two. Thank you, Michael Leslie, for the telephone call. Hello there, caller.
Hi, I'd like to play Spot the Difference.
Okie dokie. What differences can you spot there, caller?
The one on the left has a nice pretty dress on. Yeah, I like that.
Les McCann and Eddie Harris.
That's great. Hello there, caller.
Hello.
Hey, what's up, caller?
What's up?
Do you want to find the differences, David?
No, I want to play a different game.
Which game, David?
I want to know what exactly Mr. Sloat has in that bag. Is that possession of cocaine?
What? There was no bag on the show.
Yeah, I know what he's talking about.
I don't know. He was handing out bags to help me carry things in bags. Hello there, caller.
Hello.
Hello there.
Hi. I know where the peanut is.
Okay, where's the peanut?
It's under number two.
Let's have a look. That's right,
yay.
Caller. You found the peanut.
Right on. Right on, buddy. Nice move.
Where's the noob today?
Well, the noob.
That's what I'd like to know.
Who's this joker?
This is Mr. Sloat. He was here to find the noobs so he could help
he
find.
Call me a joker.
He's not the joker. He's a nice, friendly guy. But he's here to find the noob to help find the noob's dad. But the noob's not
you
here.
Think I'm a joke. You think I'm a joke, do you, buddy? Do you? You think I'm a joker?
Yeah. What is happening?
How do you like that?
Okay. Hello there, caller. Hello there, how are you today, caller?
I'm fine.
How are you today, caller?
I'm fine.
What can we do for you?
Oh, what game are we playing?
We're playing Find the Differences.
Okay, well, I can't see, but my wife will help me. How's that?
That sounds good. Why can't you see, buddy?
Talk to him. What's the differences? They're on the chest.
We already know that one.
Okay, pink socks, bow tie.
Got that.
Got it.
Look at the time of the clock.
Already know it.
Tattoo.
We already got that one.
Alright, let's have the peanut done or something.
Someone's feeding him what to do,
yeah,
man.
We may as well.
Somebody
just
is feeding him what to do.
That's true.
I bet you that was a caller that called in earlier. Now he hands the phone to his dad or something.
I'm partially blind. I can't see the TV because I can see the peanut if we do that.
Okay, let's hide.
Well, good for you, man. No, it's good. You know, it's good you're calling in and stuff. Good for you.
Okay, where do you want to hide the peanut?
I don't know. Number three.
That sounds like as good a place as any. Okay, what's your name, buddy?
Roland.
Roland, it's nice to meet you. Maybe we'll talk to you again, buddy.
Take care.
Okay, so I want to ask you, how are you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Now what?
I'm starting to loosen up a little bit. I feel a little bit better.
Yeah. What are you
Mary
going
Beth's
to do?
Mary Beth smiling once in a while. She flipped out when I went towards the camera.
That's right.
I don't know what was going on.
Mr. Sloat, I want to know.
I don't think she liked my little girl.
If the noob, that's a pretty little girl. If the noob was here tonight, what would you have done?
I ask him where his father's at.
And then what would you have done with his father?
Go find his father. I think he's in Wisconsin.
Okay, that's possible. Hello there, caller.
Or an Elkhorn. Where's Jessica?
What other games you got there?
We have find the differences, and there are still a couple more differences to find.
Oh, what about the clock?
We already got that difference.
How about the eyeball?
Got it. Okay, I'm going to give you a hint. Look at the hand.
Look at the hand. One looks like a girl hand, and one looks like a guy hand.
One of the fingers is missing.
Oh.
And now look at the mask. Look at the mask.
Okay, yeah, it does look a little funny. I know the eyeball in the middle.
And how about the colors on the mask?
White and some pink maybe?
The colors are reversed. Okay, now look at his muscle.
Oh yeah, look at 46 pythons.
That's right. You win the game. What's your name, buddy?
My name is David Orr.
Right on, baby.
Yeah, where's that bag?
There it is, my friend.
No bag.
I'll send you that bag.
It's just the bag to, to carry my salt in. Okay. I want to remind you guys that if you want...
Glad that guy likes the idea of getting a bag of that in the mail.
It does.
I got a bag from Amsterdam one time, man. That was some good powder.
Okay. If you want to send us an email, remember us, email@talkinfunny.com. And we have another email to read. It's Sasha and the Noob. I've been wondering that if a tree falls in the woods, is there a sound? Did the tree fall by itself, or did someone chop it down to tick off the environmentalist, or was it the beaver? I'm so confused. From Ron in North Canton. Well, Ron, it was a beaver.
Who is that?
They said Jerry Mathers is the beaver, but he's pretty old.
And Jerry Mathers as the beaver.
You're dating yourself, Mr. Sloat. Well, have one more email.
I'm dating myself? I got a girl.
Okay, I say figure of speech. One more quick email because it's so nice. From Bill, our new best buddy Bill. Every Tuesday night I watch your show. I think it's the funniest thing on TV. Why MTV or MTV2 hasn't picked you up is a mystery to me.
Why not Comedy Central? What's MTV2 for, or HBO?
Let's be nice.
What's
to
he
him?
Shooting low for?
I called last show and asked the noob to play a song and have the cowboy do a dance. I laughed so hard at home. I'm looking forward to seeing more episodes. I would love to come on the show sometime and be a guest. Is that possible? I would wear a funny hat and talk about sandwiches. Thanks, Bill. Well, Bill, that's definitely a possibility.
Yeah, Little Toes was funny.
We might
you
have
lost it when he started dancing.
I did,
man.
Lose it. We might have.
I was just coming out of the shower, cleaning some. I was messy. That I was all covered in.
Probably just a little mess.
Well, I was messed. I was messed up. I had to do a job.
That's true.
And then, so I was dirty. And I came out, and there was Little Toes dancing in front of that. Was good.
That's pretty cute.
That was good. I lost it, man.
Me too.
I almost dropped my bag.
Don't drop the bag. But Bill, maybe we'll have you on the show. But first, we have to make sure you're not, a scary guy who's going to hurt us. But it's good to hear from you, so give us a call again sometime.
I'm not going to hurt you, Sasha.
Oh, we know that. You're pretty much going to hurt the noob, is what I'm afraid of. But, let's take another couple of phone calls before we have to go. Hello there, caller.
Hey, hold on a second.
So, I heard a toilet flush.
Is this a guy? Is this the guy that flushes the toilet?
Yeah, but you didn't do it with much gusto tonight, buddy. You have to kind of use it to punctuate your sentence, not underplay it. Hello there, caller.
Hello.
Hello there, how are you today?
Good.
What's your name, little girl?
Jamisha.
Jamisha,
do you like dolls, Jamisha?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll get you a doll from France.
Okay.
Or what? One from Amsterdam.
What can we do for you, Jamisha?
I'd say a game.
Well, the show is almost over, so thank you for the call. Hey, we are here every single Tuesday night, so take a look at www.talkinfunny.com to watch all the episodes, and we'll see you next week, that we hope.